My name is Andrei Lazarescu. I'm the supervising producer for FIFA Switch.
So let's talk about what are some of the key differences on the Switch version compared to the Xbox and PC, Xbox and PS4 versions.
Yeah, so obviously building on from FIFA 18, this is a custom built engine that we designed and created specifically for the Switch. So everything about the game is different. But you also find commonalities because at the end of the day, this is a game of football. It's still a sport with certain specific rules. So you'll see here, for example, in the images already Champions League, which is returning to FIFA after a decade. And it's in Switch as well, not just as a standalone tournament, but also integrated in career mode alongside Europa League and the Super Cup, integrated into the new kickoff where people will be able to play with their friends the Champions League final directly. It's also going to be featured in Ultimate Team through various pieces of content released in the year. And obviously the standalone tournament itself. No, everything's different.
Everything's different.
Everything's different. This is a different type of FIFA. It's we look at it as being more of a portable version of FIFA that people can enjoy on the go, while the other versions they can't. They can't even play Ultimate Team on the go. But if you're alluding to Journey being absent, yes, Journey is still absent. You will not see Alex Hunter here, but at the same time, there's so much depth in content that has been added this year that I hope people do not feel its absence critical. So, for example, we're adding something that players demanded the most last year, the ability to play with friends online. You'll be able to play online friendlies, both in FIFA and in Ultimate Team, over a 5-match season, with as many friends as you want.
So talk about what you learned from the last FIFA game you made for Switch that you've applied and improved upon on this version.
Yeah, so for sure. As the team got more familiar and more used to how the platform works, what are its strengths, how they can better optimize things, visuals is one of the most striking things, and animations, and you'll see that immediately in the game, even in this Champions League final that I'm showing here. For example, we've introduced pitch degradation, which might seem like a small thing when talking about it, but it actually makes a really impactful difference in terms of how immersed you are in the match itself. Because as the match progresses, you can see the pitch degrade exactly where you made a sliding tackle, exactly where a battle was fought. Lightning and shadows have been redone as well, animations have been added into the game, all with the purpose of making it more refined, more defined, and also to better immerse you in that atmosphere of within a stadium.
Is there crossplay on this version of FIFA with Xbox and PS4?
No, there's no crossplay across any of the FIFA versions. We would love to have that as developers, there's a lot of conversations to be had even between first parties and so Sony, Microsoft, and Nintendo.
So what's the specs of the game in handheld mode and in docked mode?
So in docked mode, it's the same as last year, nothing changed. 1080p, 60 frames per second, and handheld 720p, 60 frames per second.
When does FIFA 19 for the Switch come out?
September 28th. Same time across all of the platforms.